Hey guys, welcome back to another video of Fox Android. So in today's video, we're gonna learn how to implement navigation rod into our Android application, right? So let me show you first what we're gonna get by the end of the tutorial, right? You must be able to see my mobile screen, right? So here you can see that there is an activity and nothing is there. I've just written navigation rod tutorial, and on the top left corner there is this burger sign, right? So if I click on this burger sign, you can see this drawer navigation drawer comes up, right? It comes up to the screen, and here you can see there are various options, and on the top side, we'll start from the top, there is the name of the user, a nice looking round profile picture. Then below the name there is a username and followers, following, and the options are there: home, messaging, trash setting, login, share and ratings, right? So if I click on any of these options, let me click on home. If I click on home, the drawer is hidden, the nice looking toast is roast, that home is clicked. I haven't done anything with these options. I've just made the methods. You can do you can do anything according to your application. So this is what we'll be making in this tutorial, right? So I request you to watch this tutorial till the end, because by the end of the tutorial you'll be able to implement the front end and the back end of this navigation drawer. So without wasting any time, let's get started. Okay guys, for this drawer navigation, we will be needing some libraries. So let me first add the libraries. If I just go to build.gradle, so the first thing we need is Google Material Library. See, in new version of Android Studio, like from 4.1, 4.2, it's automatically added to your build.gradle once you create the project. But if it is not already there, then you can simply implement this. You can just type in this com.google.android.material and this one, right? So it will be added to your project. And the second library you'll be using for that round image you must have seen on the top of the navigation drawer, I've just copied this. You can also write this. Just to save the time, I'll copy and paste it here. Then we have to click on sync now. Okay, the library has been added. It's syncing right now. It will be done. Okay, it's done. So right now what I'll do is I'll start making the drawer. I'll just do the coding, then explain it between, right? I'll write some code, then explain it, then write some code, then explain it. By that it'll save some time, right? So first we'll do the front end, then we'll do the back end, right? So I'll start doing the front end first, right? Okay guys, what I've done here is I've just added all the vector assets that we'll be needing in our navigation row. If you have seen, there were many options like home message, and the icon was there in front of each option, right? So I've added all the vector assets here. Then we'll be requiring these two colors. I'll let you know where we need these colors. So I have added these colors. And one more thing, for this tutorial I've added us this profile picture, right, to make it visible there on the top of the navigation bar. But in real time scenario, you have to fetch it from the users or like online server or cloud, right? But for this tutorial sake, I've just put it in the drawables folder and we'll use it there, right? Okay guys, what we have done here is we have added a menu resource file, right? In the menu resource file, we have added various items, set the icons of it and set the ID. So we have just designed this thing. Now we need to design the header, right? Where you can see the profile picture and that followers and the username, right? Now we're gonna design that. Okay guys, here we have designed the header as well, right? So here you can see this was the header that I was talking about. There is a nice round picture, the name of the user ID, the followers and the following. So for this, what we have done is we have just created a new layout file in which we have considered a relative layout and that added all these elements. I think this is self-explanatory, right? So this is the style we have added, view we have added that makes a line. I guess there will be some rendering problem, that's why it's not visible. So once we install it in the cell phone, then it will be visible. So I guess what we have done till now, you must have understood it, right? So if you have any doubts or you think that something is missing, you can just comment down. I'll be keeping this tutorial till here only because I don't want to just go in a single round and fill all the things in a single go, right? So you don't understand. So till now what we have done is I'll just summarize. We have just designed this navbar and the header for this, right? So in the next tutorial, what we'll do is we'll implement this in an activity, right? And we'll make a top bar, right? So we'll add a burger sign there. We'll just finish the front end in the next tutorial. So you guys do tell here, right? I'll be uploading the source code for this on the GitHub. The link for that will be in the description below, so you can check it out in case you have any doubt or there is some mismatch, the things are not looking like they are looking here in the tutorial. So you can check the source code, but first of all you should try to code it yourself for the better understanding, right? So guys, if you have any doubt, make sure to comment down, right? Or you can DM me on Instagram. The Instagram username will be there on your screen right now. So that was it for today's video. If you like the video, make sure to hit that like button. And if you're new to this channel, make sure to hit the subscribe button and bell notification icon so you can get the notification for the next video, right? So that is it for today's video. Bye.